Hello everybody, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to explain you how to install Python Pipx in our Windows 11. Pipx is a Python package and dependency management software, and which is very useful when managing dependencies. All right, let's see how we can install the Python Pipx. First, let's go to the official website of python-pipx.org. And this is the official website and might change from time to time. And this is the website at the time of recording. Now, first step what you have to do is that go to the documentation. If you click on the documentation, and this is what the documentation I'm seeing. And first step you need to see is that what are the system requirements? The first system requirements is we should have the Python version which is greater than 3.8+. Make sure that you have the required system recommendations and also the operating systems. Pipx supports the three operating systems, Linux, Mac OS, and Windows. As I'm trying to install in the Windows operating system, which is a bit complicated compared to Linux or Mac. All right, I'm assuming that you're having the Python version greater than 3.8 or whatever the version that is given at the point of time. And make sure that you have the required Python version and just go to the step number two. And step number two, which is the installation of the Python Pipx. There are different ways that we can install the Pipx. The first it shows with the Pipx. Pipx is not the general pip that generally you'll have, something like pip3 or the pip that will come by default with the Python. It's not that pip. This is something different. So in order to know more about this pip, you can click on the official documentation of the Pipx and where you can see like how we can install this Pipx. Pipx currently works for Mac, Linux, and Windows. And in order to install this Pipx, there are different ways. For Macs, you need to use this following command. And for Linux, you can use the following command and install it. And whereas for Windows, it's not pretty straightforward. For Windows, you need to install via scoop. Again, what is scoop? In order to know more about scoop, you can click on this link and this will go to the official documentation of the scoop. And here you go. This is the scoop is also the command line interface. It's a command line installer for Windows. You can either use the scoop, and in order to install the scoop, you need to use this following command. Okay. So these are the different ways that we can install it. Again, in order to install the scoop, what you have to do is you need to run the following command in the Windows PowerShell. Let me do this. First, what I can do is let's go to my Windows PowerShell. And this is my Windows PowerShell. Just simply copy and paste the following commands that was given here. So let's copy it and go to your PowerShell. And paste this here and press enter. Now again, copy it and paste it here, press enter. And this will download the scoop for you. All right, we have successfully installed scoop. And in order to know more about it and in order to get some help on scoop, you can simply type scoop help and press enter. And this will give you some help and all the command line interface and etc. Okay, this is really cool. Now, what you can do is that in order to install any kind of apps, we just need to use the command which is install. Now, what we can do, let me go back here, and on Windows, what you can see is scoop install pipx. Let's execute this command. Let's copy this and go to my Windows PowerShell. Let me clear it and paste it here. Press enter. All right, now I have successfully installed Pipx. Now go back to the official documentation of Python Poetry, and we can use a very simple way to install the Poetry, which is pipx install Poetry. Let's type the following command, or you can click on this copy to clipboard. Let's copy to clipboard and open your PowerShell and paste pipx install Poetry and press enter. Alright, now we can see that we have successfully installed the Poetry. But however, we got some warning message, something like the current user, this is the user, and which is not there in the path environment. Actually, it is looking for .local/bin, which is not there in my environment. So that's what it's saying, that these apps will not be globally accessible until the path is updated. So what you can do is that in order to do this, I need to run the pipx ensure path to automatically add it, or manually modify your path in your shell config or so on. Okay, anyway, what I can do is that let me check whether I can access the Poetry by typing the following command, Poetry, maybe just to look into some of the options here, which is the Poetry @preview_version. Poetry @preview_version. Okay, which means that I am unable to identify the path. So let me type the pipx ensure path and press enter. Okay, now let's type the following command. Okay, I'm still not able to see this. What I can do is let me open my computer, and let me go to my C, and what it is saying is that it should be find in the version, which is my user .local/bin. Okay, let me go to that file. Okay, this is, I'm in the C, and go to users, this is my user, and let's check .local. Yeah, .local is there, which is actually created just now. And under this, let's see bin, and I can see the Poetry is there, but still why Poetry is not working. Okay, let me check once again with the different command, Poetry_version. All right, still I'm not able to find. Let me do one thing, let me close it, and let's go close the Windows PowerShell. Let me open the PowerShell again, because it's supposed to be there in this path. Let's type Windows PowerShell. Okay, now let's type Poetry @Poetry_version. I'm supposed to see this. Yes, if you see this message that Poetry and followed by the version, which means that we have successfully installed Poetry in our Windows. If you are still not able to see this message, something like Poetry version .1.8.3 or something, whatever the version that you have installed, which means that this environmental, which means that the path that whatever we are seeing now, which is the .local/bin, which is not actually set in your environmental variables. What we can do is that you need to manually set that in some of the cases. So in order to set this, go to search and type environmental variables. You can see they edit the system, environmental variables. And let me open this. And in the system environmental variables, there is a environment variable is there. Just click on this. And under user environmental variables, there you can see the path. This is the path which is very much useful for us. And in this path, click on edit. And this is all the path that was actually automatically added. And what actually we need to see is this path. Users and whatever the path that whatever you see, and .local/bin. So this is what the path I'm actually looking for. If you can't able to see the path, something like /user/your username /.local/bin, if you're not seeing this, then you need to edit it or you need to create it. How you can create it? Just click on new and copy the path. Let's copy this path and okay, and you need to paste it here, and then you need to click on okay. Since this path is automatically set for me, I'm not doing this. In your case, if you are not able to see this, then you need to do exactly same thing what I'm doing. Okay, so this is how you need to do, or you need to make sure that the path whatever is there, it is set in the environmental variables. Hope you like this, and now you can able to see the message something like Pipx and followed by version. And if you can able to install the Pipx in your Windows operating system, then please like, share and comment to this video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel Data Science Anywhere.